The term long COVID has been used to describe patients who have had medical problems persist long after the coronavirus has left their system.
And there are no good treatment or diagnosis for this long COVID. And so we really wanted to look into why there would be such long-lasting consequence from an acute viral infection.
For the past several years, my lab has been working to develop a new technology to detect previously undiscoverable autoantibodies that patients have. So when COVID hit, we had a hypothesis that autoantibodies could be involved.
This study, which compared uninfected and infected samples, discovered high numbers of these autoantibodies in infected patients.
Antibodies are molecules that are made by the immune system that bind to pathogens like the SARS-CoV-2 and protect us. However, sometimes our immune system makes antibodies against our own cells, and those are known as the autoantibodies.
Sometimes these autoantibodies act kind of like friendly fire, meaning the immune system is unfortunately misdirected an attack toward one of the body's own proteins,
essentially making these people unable to control the virus.
And this can have a wide variety of potential adverse effects to the patient.
And in other cases, we found autoantibodies against different cell types that are found in different tissues, like the blood vessels or the brain. And when these types of antibodies bind to the cells, it can cause damage, because it will try to attack these cells as if they were, you know, invaders.
These many different diverse antibodies against the different tissues could explain, at least in part, why we see so many different dimensions of COVID and why some patients get certain symptoms and not others, why some patients get long-lasting symptoms and others don't. Those autoantibodies, you know, stick behind as an unfortunate legacy of the virus, and in theory, they could contribute to some of these long COVID, post-COVID syndromes.
These autoantibodies have been seen in autoimmune diseases like lupus and rheumatoid arthritis.
Drugs and medicines that are used to treat the autoimmune disease might be applicable to treating some of these patients that develop autoantibodies. But first, we need to identify whether or not the long COVID patients also have autoantibodies.
We are just now obtaining samples from these patients with post-COVID syndrome, and so we're going to be able to test some of those ideas. But this is a very, very plausible mechanism. And really, you know, I'd say one of the first glimpses into, you know, ways that long COVID could come about.
While autoantibodies may be a potential therapeutic target, it is unlikely that the SARS-CoV-2 vaccine will elicit these destructive antibodies.
During the COVID-19 disease, what happens is that there is a large amount of inflammatory responses that are generated, which breaks open our own cells and reveals some of these autoantigens. However, the vaccine itself is not going to induce this type of inflammatory responses that could trigger the development of autoantibody. So we are not concerned that the vaccine will elicit the same kind of responses.